dress up. This is really simple. It just means to wear really nice clothes for a special occasion. Yeah, maybe if there's like a really big event, maybe like a wedding. If you're going to a wedding, you don't want to wear shorts and you don't want to wear just like a really old t-shirt. You want to wear a nice button-down t-shirt, maybe with a tie and a jacket over it, and nice shoes and nice pants. That would be dressing up. Some jobs, you know, if you have a really high-power job, you also have to dress up there, right? If you work for like a really big company and you're a really big manager, you have to wear a suit and you have to look really professional. Some jobs, you don't have to dress up. Maybe if you're a writer, like me, then you don't really have to dress up. I can just wear my shirt and my, you know, normal jacket, and I can just not be dressed up. Another kind of common phrase, maybe not as common as dress up, is to dress down. Maybe after you get home, after work, a long day of work, then you finally take off your clothes, you get comfortable, and you wear your shorts and whatever you wear at home, you're dressing down. So kind of the opposite of dressing up would just be dressing casually, right? Casually is just like everyday clothes, you know, maybe you're just wearing your jeans or whatever. But maybe it's like a special night out and you're going out to Itaewon and you're celebrating a big birthday, then you want to get dressed up. You know, maybe girls are going to wear like a really nice dress, maybe guys are going to wear a really nice shirt. So there's dressing up and there's dressing casually.
We decided not to dress up. We decided not to dress up.
Alright, any final words?
If you guys are studying English really hard, make sure you reward yourself. Go get dressed up, go out at night, and go have fun with your friends.
English. 자, 여러분들, 제가 드레스업 한 것 같아요? 저 평소 때 이렇게 그냥 다니긴 합니다, 그쵸? 저는 정장이나 이런 거 입지 않고 그냥 편안하게 좀 다니는 편이거든요. 이럴 때는 그냥 dress casually 이렇게 말을 하면 돼요, 그쵸? I like dressing casually 이렇게 말하면 되는데요. 사실 저도 이제 결혼식에 가는 경우가 있잖아요, 그쵸? 그리고 가끔 가다가 이제 잡 인터뷰도 합니다. 제가 인터뷰를 보거든요. 그럴 때는 그냥 이렇게 가는 것보다는 dress up 하고 가는 게 좋습니다. 쉽게 말하면 뭐냐면 약간 좀 이제 정장을 입는 것이 될 수도 있겠고요. 평소 때보다 좀 더 이제 차려입고 간다고 생각하시면 돼요. 그쵸? 데이트 상대를 만날 때요. 그냥 캐주얼하게 가는 것보다는요. 깔끔하게 입고 가는 게 되게 중요하잖아요. 그럴 때도 드레스업을 사용할 수 있습니다. 결국은 드레스업 같은 경우는 무조건 정장을 입는다 이런 의미가 아니라 평소 때보다 좀 더 차려입는다 정도의 느낌이라고 보시면 되기 때문에 결국은 상당히 주관적인 거라고도 여러분들이 생각하시면 될 것 같아요. 자, 그리고 드레스 캐주얼이라는 표현이 바로 드레스업의 반대말이라고 제가 말씀드렸죠. 이 dress down이라는 표현 같은 경우는 사실 그렇게 많이 사용하지 않는다고 해요. 원어민들 사이에서. 근데 dress down 하면요. 뭐 보통 한 두 가지 정도 느낌이 있을 것 같습니다. 그냥 편안하게 옷을 입다라는 표현도 있겠고요. 아니면 그냥 집에 가서 그냥 편안하게 옷 벗고 있는 거잖아요. 그렇죠? 편안하게. 보통 집에 가면 다 옷 벗잖아요. 그렇죠? 아마 팬티를 입고 있겠지만.
dress down Friday. Dress down Friday. Dress down Friday.
Don't feel like you have to dress up. I mean, we're super cash here. Don't feel like you have to dress up. I mean, we're super cash here. Don't feel like you have to dress up. I mean, we're super cash here. Don't feel like you have to dress up. I mean, we're super cash here. Don't feel like you have to dress up. I mean, we're super cash here.
Can I go home? I'm just gonna put a t-shirt.
I think it's great. Some people dress up, so it's okay.
Can I go home? I'm just gonna put a t-shirt.
I think it's great. Some people dress up, so it's okay.
Can I go home? I'm just gonna put a t-shirt.
I think it's great. Some people dress up, so it's okay.
Can I go home? I'm just gonna put a t-shirt.
I think it's great. Some people dress up, so it's okay.
Can I go home? I'm just gonna put a t-shirt.
I think it's great. Some people dress up, so it's okay.
자, 여하튼 그래서 오늘 표현 dress up이라는 표현 살펴봤고요. 자, 우리 그러면 또 다음 시간에 뵙도록 하겠습니다. See you guys next time. Bye bye.